Birds.
As for Alabama, you can see on this map, much of the state is in that very high risk category. That means the number of cases is staying the same or increasing.
Today, Mobile's political and health leaders raising the level of urgency in the fight against COVID.
Our investigative reporter Brendan Kirby was at that news conference today, and Brendan, still no mandatory masks or vaccines.
Yeah, that's right, Lanice and Shelby. Local officials clearly are reluctant to take that step, but the city of Mobile is changing the way it operates. All four hospital systems in Mobile are on diversion. That means ordinarily they'd be sending people to other facilities. Of course, with all hospitals facing the same capacity limits, the practical effect is that hospitals are forced to find space within. Effective yesterday, new rules for city workers are in effect. Travel by employees is restricted. Employees are strongly urged to wear masks. Remote meetings are back. When possible, employees are asked to communicate via Zoom rather than in person. Mayor Sandy Stimson, County Commission President Masaria Ludgood, and hospital administrators all also are strongly recommending people get vaccinated. Mayor Stimson says the city and the University of South Alabama Health System are planning on Monday to expand the drive-through clinic at the Civic Center. And tomorrow from 1 to 4, there will be a vaccination clinic at Government Plaza for folks who work for the city, county, and judiciary. Their families will also be eligible.
Where we are is that it is a personal decision that everyone has to make to get a vaccine. And we will continue to share information. Hopefully, there will be a tipping point where you realize this is the best interest for you and your family.
But Mayor Stimson reiterated that he's not ready to mandate that. He says that's a call for the state and local health departments. Now, coming up at Fox 10 News at 5, I'll have a closer look at what all this is doing to area hospitals. Reporting live, Brendan Kirby, Fox 10 News.